Hey everybody, it's me, John Lorden. Welcome to another episode of Johnny Vlogs for today, August 14th, 2017. Hope you all had a very... Someone's trying to contact me. Oh, I am most welcome. Well, thank you, Lisa. Who's Lisa, you might ask? We're going to talk about her really soon. But let's get back to the vlog. Before we get started on today's topic, which we're talking about child safety, or at least one aspect of child safety. So I think it's a fairly important topic. Let me first thank some new Patreon supporters. Donna Edwards actually increased her pledge. Thank you so much, Donna. Margaret Werderitz, hope I'm saying that last name right, came in with a very big pledge. Thank you so much, Margaret. Really appreciate that. Jerry Cannon is also now pledged. Hey, Jerry, as well as Oliver Peter. Thank each and every one of you so much for helping to keep me here doing what I love doing. Also, a very big thank you to James Reed, who had some issues using Patreon because he was getting taxed pretty heavily from where he was doing that. So he wanted to send me some money via PayPal, which is amazing. Thank you so much, James. I really, really appreciate that. Outside of all that, I have to give a quick shout out to Seema Ramji, who is a new Patreon supporter, and her boyfriend, Mario. Hope I'm saying that right. How else can you say Mario? Mario, Mario, Mario. I've just run out. I hope one of those is correct, but I just wanted to give a quick shout out to him as well. Thank you so much. Okay, so back to today's topic. What am I talking about here? Well, I had a very good supporter of the channel who has been helping me out quite a bit now, Christina Lewis, who sent me a website for McGruff safety kits. And actually, I'm going to do something I don't do on Johnny Vlogs too often here. We're going to share the screen so you can see it with me. At McGruffSafeKit.com, you can come here to request a free US kit or a free Canada kit. And these kits are essentially for you to catalog information about your child in case they go missing. Some of the most important details: height, weight, eye color, hair color, including some methods for getting their fingerprints and some suggestions for collecting DNA samples. I thought, hey, this is a great thing. I have to let my audience know about this. Well, I did some looking into safety kits because there's a lot of different places that offer them. And I started seeing these articles about child safety kit scam. Yeah, and I was kind of curious about it, so I looked into it a little more, and apparently, on Facebook in particular, it seems like there was a message that was going around for, you know, get a free child safety kit. People were signing up for that, and then they would be contacted by someone who was arranging a time for them to be home so they could come by to help them fill out the safety kit. And they would usually be also asking for, hey, make sure that your spouse is home at the same time so we can all do this together. Then when the person shows up, they're actually a life insurance salesman that is trying to sell a policy behind the guise of this child safety kit, which I have to admit makes me kind of angry in a way, because I don't think it's too hard to... do the right thing to create a, not really a business necessarily, but something more like a charity, reach out to people that would sponsor these safety kits to have them delivered for free. I mean, I know that you can't make anything in this world happen, at least to this scale, without having some means of financial backing. But I truly believe in my heart of hearts that there are donors out there that would donate money for this to happen. I don't think you need to have a business hook that is coming in after the fact there to turn this into basically getting salesmen into your home so that they can pitch you something else. Now, outside of that, I also saw this article at WOWT.com. And it's saying that police are actually warning of child safe kit boxes. This story goes into one account in particular where there was a local laundromat and this box showed up there. They looked at this box and they could not tell who was providing it, who was the company that was providing this safety kit. Apparently, the police took this box and destroyed all the entries in it, because if you think about real world phishing scams, what a great way to get a bunch of personal information, right? You can get someone's name, their address, their phone number, how many kids they have, all on this card behind the guise of giving them this child safety kit for free. You take that information, run it back, and do whatever criminals do with that type of information. So this one I would kind of expect. I would say this is a little... I don't know which one. In my eyes, this one is not quite as bad as the insurance salesman, believe it or not. This is a scam that you should be wary of. You know, someone that wants to collect your personal information in a box somewhere. It doesn't even say who the organization is on it. I think some good, stringent common sense could help you not fall into that situation, where the other ones, where you have a whole website that is, you know, telling you about this awesome safety kit and you see customer testimonials about this safety kit. That's a whole different thing. So, I don't know. I've got a couple articles here. I'm going to put them in the description box below so you can take a look at them for yourself. But then I really wanted to kind of solve this problem, and I wanted to be sure to give you guys a good suggestion. So on the McGrawSafeKit.com website, they actually have a customer service agent that just kind of pops up if you stay on the website long enough. And I engaged with that customer service agent. Now, I don't know if this is a real person or if it's a bot. It kind of feels like a chat bot to me. And I asked several questions in the first blurb. They only answered one of the questions. But here's kind of how the conversation went. First of all, I asked, do they sell the information to third parties? And is someone going to deliver this item to the home? Basically, is someone going to come knocking on your door? Of those two questions, they only answered, they don't sell their information to third parties. And they specifically said, we don't sell our information to third parties, which gives me just a little cause for concern, because that doesn't mean that they don't have some kind of prearranged agreement where they are giving that information to another party. But the conversation went on and I said, well, are the kits being mailed? Do they just come in the mail, or how do they get delivered? And Lisa, who I think is a chatbot, let me just say again, Lisa replied, you get the kit by email. Which I thought, okay, well, that sounds pretty safe. But on their homepage, they talk about this, the fingerprinting ink that is supposed to come with this, and that it's, you know, child safe fingerprinting ink. So I asked Lisa, what about this ink? How does the ink arrive? And then all of a sudden, the chatbot seemed to slow down, and it took a really long time. I kept asking in different ways. You mentioned on your homepage about the ink. What about the ink? How does the ink show up? Eventually, it kicked back, or she kicked back. I don't know. It could be a person. She kicked back with a response that someone will come to your home that basically is going to help you fill out this information card, which... unfortunately to me, I can't say with 100% certainty that that means that it's a salesman, but I'm pretty sure it's a salesman. They're not going to have someone driving around delivering ink to places. It would be much more economical for them to just mail it. So unfortunately, I believe the McGruff Safe Kit is one of these types of, hey, here's a free child's kit scams to get salesmen in your door. And I think that is very, very unfortunate. McGruff the crime dog, been around since I was a kid. I remember him seeing him on materials way back when I was in school. And to see that the brand is being used in that way, when it could, I'm telling you, it could just as easily be funded by some good, caring people out there that have some extra money that say, what are your yearly operations? How can we make this work for you guys so that this is truly free? I don't know. From what I'm seeing based on my interaction with Lisa, let me just say, I don't feel comfortable about the McGruff Safe Kit, particularly if they were going to deliver it to you in email. Why wouldn't they just only ask for your email address at that point? Why do they need home information, address information, that kind of stuff? So how do we solve this problem? Well, luckily, there is a great little organization I've talked about before called NCMEC, or the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children. And they actually have a special link at www.missingkids.com/child ID, where they provide basically the same type of thing that the McGruff website was promising. But it's a child ID kit that you just download from their website. And if you're curious to see what it is, here it is. It's essentially a questionnaire, and that's really all that we need here. You place the kid's photo on it, address, city, state, zip, country, sex, race, ethnicity, hair color, eye color. Then they have a chart for the height and weight and the date, which is a very important thing. If you do this once and then your kid goes missing 2 or 3 years later, that information isn't going to be accurate. So you need something to kind of prompt you to update this. Distinguishing characteristics, medical information, and then right down here, a nice section for the fingerprints. Of course, no ink is provided here, so you're going to have to figure out where to get your ink from, but that could be a fun little project. I know when I was a kid, I loved playing with ink and putting my fingerprints all over the place. Outside of that, they've got tips on this page. In particular, the ones that really got me, first of all, dental x-rays, charting, and bite impressions for you to get copies of those and to keep them with this record. I think that's a great, great point. They're talking about fingerprints, of course. DNA sample. It is simple for you to collect a sample on your own. Items rich in DNA include an old toothbrush allowed to air dry, baby teeth, a hairbrush used exclusively by your child for at least 1 month, or dried blood from a bandage. These items should be placed in a brown envelope licked shut by your child. Why are they doing that? Because the envelope then also has another sample of your kid's DNA from where they licked it shut. The envelope should be labeled and stored in a cool, dry, and readily accessible place. They also mention medical reports that could be included with this. Very good information here. If you're a parent, I highly recommend you check out missingkids.com/child ID. Print this out. And then set some type of reminder to remind yourself that you should update this. Maybe every 6 months, just, you know, go into your Google Calendar, set up a recurring reminder for every 6 months. Hey, update my child ID kit. This information could be so critical if you are faced in one of those terrible situations that we talk about on this channel all the time, unfortunately, of a child that goes missing. Now, outside of that, the FBI has also developed a child ID safety app. And I was looking into different apps because I was trying to find something that would essentially do what we were just talking about, just catalog the critical information, maybe store some photos. The FBI has basically thought about that since 2011. They originally came out with an app specifically for the iPhone. In 2012, they brought out the Android version. It's been updated since then, so it has more features now. One of those features includes, bing, 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 reminding you when you need to update it. It has a triggered reminder in there, so it'll let you know, hey, it's been a long time since you've updated this info on your child. Why don't you let us know the current stats on that? So to solve today's Johnny Vlogs, essentially, I highly recommend you check out that link at Missing Kids. You check out this FBI child ID app. Get it installed on your phone. Get that information cataloged. It is not stored by the FBI. It is stored on your phone. I know some people will probably be nervous about, well, I'm going to catalog my kid with the FBI. You can look into this app in the links below. They don't store the information on any servers with the FBI, nothing like that. However, if your kid goes missing, there's apparently a feature in this app where you can trigger it to notify local law enforcement. And let me just ask you, if local law enforcement is going to be triggered by someone and they see something to do with the FBI in there, or they see Joe Schmo, which one do you think they're going to pay more attention to? I think that this could be a really good thing if you're ever in that situation, that I hope you never are. So, All right, that's it for today's Johnny Vlogs. And if any of you find out more about the McGruff thing, I'm kind of heartbroken to have bumped into what feels like a sales pitch behind something like that. If you guys find out that I'm wrong about that or something, please send me more information. From what I can see, they have a Twitter account. They only have like 20 something followers. So I'm going to send this video to them. If you guys would like to explain to me where I went wrong with this methodology, if you can guarantee that you don't have some type of sales pitch behind this, please let me know. I will definitely post another video. Maybe I'll even, have one of you interviewed or something along those lines. If you're really trying to help kids and it's not in a way where you're going to be putting parents in a situation where they have to tell a salesman, no, get out of my house, I would like to support you guys. But as it looks today, based on my interaction with Lisa, I'm not really sure if that's the case. So let me just put that little disclaimer at the end of this video. Thank you so much for hanging out with me, everyone. I hope you're having a wonderful week. I'll see you here tomorrow, right back here on the Lord and Arch channel for more. Take care.